Good evening. My name is Joe. We come with Golder Associates, and we are the agent of record for Orvana's NPDES water discharge permit application. We had hoped that that would be also part of the official docket tonight, but I did want to offer a few comments about Orvana's approach to water treatment and the water treatment permitting. Golder is, among other things, designing Orvana's wastewater treatment plant, and they're handling their permitting for water discharges. And we're expecting a draft NPDES permit to be released by the DEQ relatively soon. And Orvana that will specify the state and federal requirements for Orvana's proposed discharge. And Orvana fully expects to face the most stringent discharge limitations that the state can possibly offer, including an ultra-low mercury limit of 1.3 nanograms per liter. And so as a major element of Orvana's compliance program, their water processing and handling systems are predicated on, and production systems are based on maximizing recycling of processed waters and, you know, largely eliminating the need for discharges during most of their operations. But when discharges are required, Orvana has specified state-of-the-art, very comprehensive, multi-stage water treatment plant that includes reverse osmosis to help meet the what we expect to be is the mercury limitation. And this plant is estimated to probably have a cost to construct about $25 million and cost Orvana around $2 million annually to maintain and operate. Further, the system is designed to store processed waters and when there are planned or unplanned downtime for the water treatment plant. Excuse me. And I just wanted to offer these comments to show and demonstrate what I certainly know from both personal and professional experience, Orvana's commitment to regulatory compliance, but more importantly, to environmental protection. And I certainly encourage rigorous review of their permit applications and their approvals of this important project to move forward. Thank you.
Thank you.